how feasible is it to actually introduce your tilapia fish stock to DIY fish food? Stay tuned. Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. My name is Raleigh and I have an outdoor fish keeping system. I've actually tried several experiments and system management in which I've actually shared on my channel. If you do care to visit my playlist or my list of videos, you will see that I have several experiments in which I have done, some of which have proven to be true, as you know, the arguments are, and some have not. Right? Okay, so today we're talking about DIY and tilapia fish food. Now, I keep tilapia, sterling red tilapia that has its roots from Bannabountain tilapia fish farm, right? And I share all of that in videos before. Now, how feasible is it to actually make your own, your DIY tilapia fish food? Now, I have roughly about 10 dozen or more tilapia within my entire space. Some are fingerlings, some are juveniles, and I just harvested some and consumed some. Some are bootstrap, right? Now, AZZOLA is an excellent source of feed for your tilapia. However, AZZOLA is, if you do feed your fish on AZZOLA, you will see a picture of that on the screen shortly. You will find that your fish will be lacking in some other nutrients. Nutrients in which your purchase, manufactured or imported tilapia fish feed would have had. So I've seen videos where rich persons from Indonesia, some sections from Asia itself, have actually been using different ingredients mixed with AZZOLA, such as egg yolk or egg with AZZOLA with some other little things, and they have been able to make their own tilapia fish feed. How workable is this type of tilapia fish feed? No, okay. So you have a system like mine where you have a lot of fish, right? I'm not talking about any backyard thing where in which you have like probably about a dozen, or probably have one container with fish. If you have a lot of fish, right? It is impossible, or should I say, it's very difficult for you to actually grow the amount of AZZOLA that will be needed so as to make your own DIY tilapia fish food. AZZOLA by itself is not nutritious to the fish, whilst they do, and we all know that tilapia consume like the leaves of the Elodea densa and some other plants that you might place within the space, right? These are my bootstock, right guys? So there comes a time where I have to like remove the eaten leaves of my Elodea densa, right? Because the tilapia will actually consume the leaf. That doesn't mean that I'm gonna start to feed the tilapia Elodea densa leaves. Tilapia requires fat, requires protein, requires minerals, requires calcium, and requires other nutrients that is necessary for it to, one, breed, and two, to grow, and three, to stay healthy. Now, creating your own tilapia fish feed creates more of a stress on you as the individual trying to make this work. Now, whilst I do complain every day, I come out here, I complain about my tilapia fish feed. I'm trying to open the container so that you can see, right? I complain about the feed. The feed makes the water stink. It clouded the water. And if the water is not managed properly, the fish experience a high, or should I say, increase
in ammonia, nitrates and nitrites, broken down ammonia, and you know the fish will eventually die if the water is not managed. So, you know, this is my locally produced tilapia fish feed. Over the last couple of months, I've been using, let me show you. This is my the local tilapia fish feed, right, guys? It's made up of several elements that supply the nutrients that the fish actually need. As you can see there, guys, you have some amount of corn, right? You have ingredients that provides fat, protein, calcium, and the necessary nutrients, right? I have been using Aquamax for the past couple of months, right? And I have seen wherein which Aquamax have actually allowed my fish to look a little brighter in color. But one of the side effects is that my fish is not growing as fast as they should. One, two, although this is a good thing, they have less fat, right? Because I just consumed some today, they have less fat. Three, which is a bad thing, I have not seen any babies since I've actually started to feed them the Aquamax. I'm going to be doing a video on that, and that requires me to do some reading, so I am not going to jump to that assumption just yet. But this is just my position, or should I say posit, as we would do in research. So I will let you know what I find regarding Aquamax and increased levels of testosterone within that feed. Does it actually inhibit the whole breeding process? All right, so back to the DIY feed. Now, the DIY feed, it can work if you have a small amount of fish and you are actually trying some experiments. Like, so I love to do experiments to see if it works, and just, you know, but as a within a continuum, I mean, like, constantly you're feeding 10,000, 60,000, 100,000 tilapia each day of varied size, it's an impossible task to actually do that. It's like having the two set system, because the Azzola will have to be grown within a different water space, in doing that, what you'll find other creatures, right, living within that water space, such as frogs, mosquitoes, and other insects, right? You can't put any fish in there, because it is not only tilapia that actually consume Azzola only, right? You have cichlids, and you have Oscars, and you have convicts. They too also consume Azzola. Grind up very nicely with some egg yolk, some probably some cuttings of some fish, you know, grind up really, really fine. Place it together with a little starch so as to hold everything together. With a pellet machine, it's an excellent feed, excellent source of feed for your fish. But the volume of feed that you would need so as to produce, so as to maintain a system that is commercially to make monies, it will be time consuming, right? So whilst I am not throwing out through the window that you can actually make your own tilapia food fish feed, it is very time consuming, and you'll find that eventually you either gonna have to, this is the pond that I've actually cleaned recently, you'll have to practically source feed, the floating feed, and it depends on the pellet machine. You can actually get your DIY feed to be floatable or to be sinking pellets. This is something that have been done on me from a few months ago. We have actually, you know, because, you know, being in the fish keeping thing, I have to keep abreast of what is happening right now in the world as far as fish farming is concerned. And I am realizing that a lot of persons, just for the, you know, getting the hype or getting, you know, popularity within the fish farming business, they have been trying some weird stuff, some persons have been gravitating to them, you know. But you have to look at all eventualities at the end of the day. Peace out, guys. Catch you next time. Yeah, buy your tilapia fish feed. Your fish will love you for it. Fish will get big, fat, nice, and you'll be able to enjoy a sustainable passive income. Peace out. Catch you next time. Bye bye.